What are the rotator cuff muscles and what is their function is one of the favorite questions of the examiner. So, it is the subscapularis, which is the only muscle that will medially rotate the arm among the rotator cuff muscles of the shoulder, and that is the one which is innervated by the upper and lower subscapular nerves is what you need to basically remember. The process of unlocking a fully extended knee is mainly the function of which important muscle? Popliteus. Popliteus is the one which will see to that our whenever we stand, why our knee joint doesn't flex and we fall down like a toy? Whenever we stand, why? Who maintains that extension of the tibia and fibula over that of the femur? It is the popliteus locking mechanism which you need to be very sure about. Then, if you look at the PAP joint, MCP joint and DIP joint, who is the flexor, who is the extensor? Is a favorite question of the examiner. So, what is the function of lumbrical L? When you put like L, what is happening at the MCP joint? Flexion. What is happening at interphalangeal joint? Extension. So, extension of the interphalangeal joint and flexion of the metacarpophalangeal joint is the function of lumbrical. Okay? So, what exactly will happen if there is a radial nerve palsy? Basically, the radial nerve palsy will lead to loss of extension of the metacarpophalangeal thumb. Thumb also will have metacarpophalangeal, no? The extension of that is by the radial nerve. Thumb's abduction is radial nerve. And wrist extension is radial nerve. And the fingers metacarpophalangeal extension. All the remaining fingers metacarpophalangeal flexion is by lumbrical. Whereas the finger metacarpophalangeal extension is by radial nerve is what you have to basically appreciate. Okay, flexion is by lumbricals and extension of the interphalangeal joint is by lumbricals. A interphalangeal, A metacarpophalangeal. The sensation of the fullness of the rectum, it is the stretch receptors and who carries them? It is the pelvic splanchnic nerves and nervi irrigantes is what you need to basically remember. You may be a prime minister of a country, you may be a major general of an army, when you become old, only three issues will be around you. Can I walk to the party? Arthritis. Will I be overcoming this constipation? Will I be able to have a proper urinary continence? Three major geriatric issues. So, as we are adding age to the aged people as the times go ahead, we need to be quite sure on geriatric care. One point of time will become as big a specialty like a pediatric care is what you need to be quite sure about. Pelvic splanchnicness. So, it is the sacral levels where you have S2 to S4 which will be giving rise to this pelvic splanchnicness. So, greater splanchnic nerve, lesser splanchnic nerve, what is that innervation in the anatomy? Today only you should go and review. Gut and bladder. These two things, doctor. Parasympathetic, sympathetic innervation. What is the plexus involved? Is a high yield topic which you need to point out today after going home. The body and tail, what is the main blood supply? Splenic artery. That's the reason. Whenever there is any pancreatitis, since the tail and splenic artery go close to each other, the inflammation will elicit a splenic vein thrombosis. What is the unique thing about the splenic vein thrombosis? Generally, you find what? Esophageal varices when portal hypertension is there. But splenic vein thrombosis will lead to varices along the gastric curvatures. That is a isolated gastric varices are the unique feature. Now, hereditary spherocytosis, ankyrin and spectrin deficiency, which is responsible. APTT elevation is not a feature of Henoch-Schönlein. Henoch-Schönlein is what? Vasculitic purpura. APTT is a except is missing. Should apologize. Except is missing. Char panch mistakes hote hai key mein aur composition mein. But don't tell your friends. So Murali Bhardwaj ko ye test ko jao, pura 195 mistakes. We are very good in mudslinging, no? When we were studying in Kakatiya Medical College, we used to have a nearby theater. The theater used to survive based on our feedback. Ek banda jata movie dekhta aur batayega sabko, dekho jana movie ko, kuch bhi nahi hai usme. Then all class will not go. So that way, so we used to blackmail that fellow. Pura jane aana hai ya nahi aana, to humko free ticket de do. Khali humko nahi. We used to have a band of guys and including their friends also. So, except, yeah. By the way, what is speciality of von Willebrand disease? Von Willebrand disease mein why APTT get prolonged? Von Willebrand factors, one more function is what other than platelet detention? Stability of factor 8. So if von Willebrand factor is deficient, factor 8 become destroyed easily, and that lead to development of prolongation of the APTT is what you have to basically remember. CVP, central venous pressure measures in the right atrium, as all of you know very well. First heart zone. State MD entrance papers will contain questions like this. Labbu means what? Dabbu means what? Even that also, if you don't answer, examiner will be disappointed. So, AV valve closure. AV valve closure. If anybody did this question wrong, free coaching. Our crash course is starting. We will crash you fully. So, if you did this wrong, but you need to prove it. In the OMR sheet, we should find that you have done wrong. That you bring your OMR sheet, I mean the result sheet, and show that question number 9 you did wrong, we'll give free coaching. Because it's our responsibility. How can we leave lab, dub are most important? No? Now, cardiac output depends on cardiac rate, but not on body surface area. You know very well cardiac output formula, stroke volume into heart rate. Even this question anybody did wrong, bring your result paper and show that question number 12 wrong, we will give free coaching. Now, what are the major metabolics? Anybody did wrong? Earlier question, no. Good. Major metabolic consequence of perturbation of the electron transport in the mitochondria, what is the consequence of it? So basically, what is the purpose of electron transport chain? What is the purpose? NADH is there though, which is produced in citric acid cycle, glycolysis, etc. That NADH will enter into the electron transport chain and deliver its reducing, the electron into the electron transport chain, which converts that into ATP. If the electron transport chain get affected, NADH cannot be converted into NAD+. If NAD+ is not regenerated, once more, you don't have NAD plus available for the NADH reproduction. So that cycle gets disturbed. Now what is wrong about gluconeogenesis? Pyruvate carboxylase, will it be inhibited or will it be stimulated by low levels of ADP? So what is the story about how to remember about these funda? Very simple. There are only two things in the entire metabolism, doctor. Fed state, garibi state, starvation state, energy rich state, energy poor state. Whenever we are in an energy rich state, what we will try to do with the glucose? We will try to store it as glycogen. We like to store it as fat. Whenever we are in an energy poor state, we try to do glycolysis, gluconeogenesis. We try to break down the glycogen. We try to break down the fatty acid. Energy production ki taraf jayega body. Only thing is you must recognize whether examiner is asking fed state or a starvation state. Similarly, a given enzyme, does it belong to which metabolic cycle? You must know. Either glycolysis ki taraf ja rahe hai, glycogen breakdown ki enzyme hai, ya glycogen ki synthesis ki enzyme hai. Agar ye malum hai to any bloody answer question in the biochemistry, you can be able to give a answer. So doctor, low levels of ADP means high levels of ADP. That means a high energy state. So gluconeogenesis is a pathway where you have got production of the glucose. And accordingly, you must evaluate. I mean, it takes a little longer time to exactly pinpoint why pyruvate carboxylase, what is stimulant and inhibitor. But this is the funda. Now, coming to carbon monoxide poisoning. If you give 100% oxygen, what will it do? The carbon monoxide will try to have affinity for hemoglobin. 100% oxygen will try to overcome that low affinity state. That's a basis of giving it. Now, lumen of endoplasmic reticulum. Once more, in biochemistry, what is another basis? Where are the different enzymes of a given metabolic pathway are located? Favorite MCQ. Quickly tell me. Fatty acid synthesis, where are they located? Come on. One single answer. Cytosol. Beta oxidation. Mitochondria. Glycolysis. Cytosol. I am becoming a LKG second class teacher. Urea cycle. Both mitochondria and also cytosol. So that is the reason, doctor. If you look at the various reactions of the gluconeogenesis, then basically the final reaction is carried out in the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum. What is the final reaction gluconeogenesis? Glucose 6 phosphate is broken down and converts into glucose. What are the reactions in glycolysis? Glucose becomes glucose 6 phosphate becomes glucose 1 6 diphosphate. Glucose 6 phosphate become fructose 6 phosphate become fructose 1 6 diphosphate. Reverse gaye to glucose 6 phosphate ultimately become glucose. That reaction of the gluconeogenesis occurs in the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum is what you have to basically appreciate. And why it occurs in the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum? There is one unique enzyme called glucose 6 phosphatase to convert glucose 6 phosphate back into glucose, and that is located in the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum. Now you tell me, doctor, glycogen is there in the liver, glycogen is also there in the muscle. Can the muscle glycogen can be broken down to glucose and contribute to blood glucose? No, only liver glycogen can be broken down and contribute to blood glucose. Because of the absence of which enzyme in the glycogen in the muscle? Glucose 6 phosphate is missing. So where is that located, doctor? It is located in the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum is what you have to basically remember. Succinate dehydrogenase in the Krebs cycle. If you want to demonstrate it, what is the best reaction? Succinate dehydrogenase ke reaction mein kya paida hota? NADH paida hota. NADH or FADH2, whatever. I could not remember. FADH2 or NADH? Huh? FADH2. I mean, a teacher like me who teaches all 19 subjects sometimes lose specifics. So, sir is telling you, when we teach the topic of glycolysis, that time for that few 10 minutes, I will remember every reaction. After that, we will dislodge it from the brain. There are more things to remember. So, sometimes few errors keep creeping. Don't worry. So, FADH2. FADH2 or NADH? Philosophy kya hai? Uska H plus ko donate karne ke liye wo tayar hai. तो एफ ए डी एच टू या एन ए डी एच टू पैदा हुआ या नहीं पैदा हुआ कैसे मालूम पड़ेगा? अगर आप कोई एच प्लस रिसिपियंट वाला डाई को इस्तेमाल करें तो. सो विच इज द वन विच विल बेसिकली डू दैट फंक्शन? टेट्रासोल रिएक्शन इज द वन विच विल एनेबल यू टू आइडेंटिफाई एज एच प्लस एक्सेप्टर. नाउ एंडोस्कोप्स आर स्टरलाइज्ड बाय साइडेक्स क्लासिकली. देन SPM is a funny subject, microbiology also. Moist heat kills everything but not Q fever, coxiella, Babesiae. Then complement fixation test is which one? Slide agglutination is which type of test? That list of five types of tests you need to remember. Wasserman's reaction. Then wheel flare, where do you find? We find it in type 1. Hypersensitivity reaction. Breast milk, you are having immunoglobulin A, secretory immunoglobulin. Then for the alternative pathway of the complement, what is required? You basically require C3, and which one is called C3 convertase? Which complement complex is called C3 convertase? Wo complement pathway mein which are nephelotoxin, which are chemoattractants, which are which is C3 convertase, which is the membrane stabilizing complex. So complement ka garam garam 10 questions will be there, doctor. 10 makki marna, there is no option. One question will come on complement. 22 year old, serum triglyceride is 1500. Then what is the best drug that you want to basically use? If anybody answered statin based answer, option A, can raise the hand. I thought of giving free coaching, isliye. No. Statins are for cholesterol. Statins are for cholesterol. Cholesterol is different from triglyceride. For triglyceride, what you use? Exercise, good control of diabetes, because insulin deficiency is the promoting factor for the triglyceride production. Insulin deficiency. Typically, if diabetes is there, what is the typical pattern of patient's lipid profile? Normal cholesterol with a high triglyceride. Lot of times you will come across. They will say, doctor, my cholesterol is normal and you know why my triglyceride is high? Because of your inactivity, diabetes, high triglyceride with a normal cholesterol. But you will be giving like a Goodlingam, Dr. Goodlingam, light 10 milligram atorvastatin even for the guy whose normal cholesterol is there with a high triglyceride. 4-5 din wo tablet lene ke baad he started having difficulty to rise from the chair. Myositis with proximal myopathy. Then what will you tell? Oh, your diabetes is progressing. Now you have developed asymmetrical or symmetrical peripheral neuropathy. That was a wrong diagnosis, because peripheral neuropathy mein why will you have difficulty in the proximal muscles? You should have in distal muscles, or paresthesia should be there. Right. No problem. We did all such stupid diagnosis and became better. MD, 3 saal kya karte doctor? Rose correct diagnosis karke, correct treatment deke, logon ko bachate kya? No. First 6 months, high mortality. All wrong diagnosis, all dopamine drip, you will be running in the repeat likhte na usme aap repeat dopamine, repeat dopamine, repeat mannitol, sub repeat likhte. Slowly your chief will be telling sabko repeat nakko likhna beta, kali antibiotic ko repeat likho, IV fluids repeat likho. Some mistakes you will do. That's the reason housemanship, medicine posting, AMC posting, casualty posting, poor entrance book ko chhod do, throw them in dustbin, put up your sleeves and work. That will help you ultimately to win the entrance. Let me tell you, entrance is all about common sense also. So serum triglycerides are high, doctor. So gemfibrozil, niacin are the ones which have an effect on triglycerides. How will niacin will do that function? Triglyceride boleto 3 acyl groups with a glycerol. Who provides acyl group? Acyl means palmitoyl group. that palmitoyl group, palmitoyl acyl CoA availability will be increased normally, unless it is increased, triglyceride cannot form. Niacin decreases the availability of those acyl groups, so the triglyceride formation doesn't occur. And who carries the triglycerides predominantly inside our body? Endogenous triglycerides are carried by VLDL, exogenous are carried by chylomicrons. So VLDL levels will come down if you are using niacin. So niacin jumtibrogyl triglyceride ke liye, statin hota hai cholesterol ke liye, is what you have to clearly understand. Now temozolomide is what? Basically oral alkylating agent. It is not acetazolamide, don't be confused. So anybody answered carbonic anhydrase inhibitor?
Wow.
No free coaching. So this is the special level of question, leg fixing question. So basically it is an alkylating agent. It will do methylation of the DNA and damage the DNA, is what you have to basically remember. All antiretrovirals which will cause nephrolithiasis, which will lead to lipodystrophy, all the side effects of the antiretrovirals you should remember. So hypertriglyceridemia, hypercholesterolemia are the severe side effects of ritonavir, is what you have to basically remember. Now 78 year old oseltamivir, Tamiflu. So how does it basically act? It prevents the release of the virion. Influenza ke bacche aur pote sab paida hoga, magar wo street mein release nahi dene dega, hone dega. Kaun? Oseltamivir is what need to be remembered. So this is the most important illustration you should remember, doctor. Viral adsorption is prevented by enfobactide. How is viral replication will occur? Various steps are there. Penetration of the virus hone ke baad uska uncoating, it has to remove its clothes, that is prevented by amantadine. After it removes the clothes, it will do the early protein synthesis. Then those early proteins which are produced will help in nucleic acid synthesis. That is prevented by your purine and pyrimidine analogs. Purine, pyrimidine analogs are there among the antiviral drugs, no? Those things. Then protease inhibitors will prevent late protein synthesis from the nucleic acid. And after the late protein synthesis, an assembly will occur and the virion become released, and that is avoided by neuraminidase inhibitors. This is the story of how we block the viruses from causing common cold, so that the teacher cannot teach in the Sunday properly, is what you need to remember. Now doctor, irritant induced bronchoconstriction. So basically if you look at the bronchial spasm, it can be due to two reasons: high vagal tone or a low sympathetic drive. Either of the two will be responsible for bronchoconstriction. That is the reason to relieve bronchoconstriction, to produce bronchodilation, what will you use? Antivagal agents are a sympathomimetic agent, like a beta agonistic agent. Salbutamol, salmeterol, they are all what? Beta agonistic, sympathomimetic. Whereas ipratropium bromide, which you use, no? Ipratropium bromide inhalation for asthma patients, that is antivagal, parasympatholytic. So tell me doctor, a favorite question of the examiner: a COPD patient is having bronchospasm, of all asthma drugs, what is the drug preferred? Ipratropium bromide. A patient is having exercise induced asthma and nocturnal asthma, what is the asthmatic drug preferred? Salmeterol is what you have to. Salmeterol is a long acting LABA, long acting beta agonistic drug, is what you need to remember. So in the crash course we have also have general medicine for 5 weekends. I personally will teach general medicine. Please do come if you have time during that time. And it will be on Saturday and Sunday. 9 to 6 on Sunday, 2 to 8 on Saturday. It is a... Not here. Here Sunday test, our regular this thing will be there. And those who attend the Sunday long day class will have the test conducted on Monday. We'll reconduct the test on Monday. So do come, we'll have a revision of general medicine in about 64 hours. I think they have given the schedule when is the general medicine. Sometime in the October after post Dashara. Now, but medicine, surgery, gynops, orthoped, that is all is APPG. There is no other APPG. Remaining things you don't read and go also you'll get seat. But if there is any compromise in this medicine, surgery, gynops, orthoped, that will be a compromising rank. Myoclonic seizure is valproate, then alcoholic hepatosteatosis. Why does it basically occur? All the alcohol that you take, what will it convert into? Acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde is broken down into, when acetaldehyde is forming, what will happen? NADH production will occur. And all that increased NADH production is the one which will be implicated in the hepatic steatosis. That excess NADH, what will it will be doing? Excess NADH, whenever it is there in the body, what will body will do? Will it break down the fat or will it form the fat? Excess NADH means excess money. When we have excess money, do we study or we don't study? Private mein seeta jata MD ka bhanne ka kya zarurat hai? Ek crore, ek flat you sell, you will get one MD seat. Right? Banjara Hills ka nowadays Arundel Pet, Brady Pet flat also is more than Jubilee Hill, Banjara Hill flat. So if you have excess energy like ATP or NADH, which is an indicator of energy state, you are having tendency towards fatty acid synthesis. When you have low NADH, you have a tendency towards fatty acid breakdown. So there is a tendency towards fatty acid synthesis, and that lead to development of fatty liver. And who is causing high NADH? All that sharab jo pire that is converting into ethanol is converting into acetaldehyde. And during that time, NADH is generated. That's a point you need to appreciate. Now, ventromedial nucleus of the hypothalamus destruction typically will lead to rage, obesity, hyperphagia, hypersexuality, etc., etc. Now, a 64-year-old, all the parameters biochemical, calcium, phosphorus, alkaline phosphatase, PTH, everything normal. But there is a fragility of the bone. Then you will think of osteoporosis. Porosis mein problem kya hota hai? Matrix mein problem hota hai. Osteomalacia and rickets mein kaha problem hota hai? Mineralization of the matrix mein problem hota hai. Jab mineralization ka problem hota hai, you will have alteration in calcium, phosphate, everything. But matrix production mein problem hota hai, jaise osteoporosis, you will have all biochemical parameters normal. So today only you should go back and read, doctor, difference between, I mean the laboratory findings, primary, secondary hyperparathyroidism, rickets / osteomalacia, osteoporosis, Paget's disease. What is the difference between them biochemically? You have to be very sure. Favorite question of the entrance examiner. One question jarur puchega. Now, MNL-avilanic acid is increased in the case of the lead poisoning, as all of you know very well. A newborn AB negative, B positive will end up in RH isoimmunization. Then type 4 hyperlipidemic pattern. Whenever there is a decreased insulin, why does it basically happen? Insulin is a lipogenic hormone. Insulin deficiency leads to development of lipolysis. So increased lipolysis will cause increased fatty acid delivery to the liver. All that fatty acid is being converted into triglyceride, and that lead to increased production of the VLDL. So high triglyceride typically happens in the case of insulin deficiency. Here's what you have to basically remember. Right? Now, oral evidence, what is except? There are few things which you don't need the oral evidence guy. Dying declaration, you can't bring the guy from heaven. Chemical examiner report. Expert opinion expressed in our mock test. Explanatory booklet doesn't require court evidence. Don't tell, I wrote like this in MD entrance because our Murali Bharadwaj sir gave it in the explanatory booklet like that. Means judge will say, bring that fellow who gave the answer like this, then I cannot come. So, expert opinion. But if the ballistic report, expert report, ballistic expert should come. As far I remember, exceptions to oral evidence, but dying declaration is there. Number two, expert opinion. Number three, evidence of the doctor recorded in the lower court is the one he need not come and tell in the higher court about. Once more, he need not reproduce. Then evidence given by the witness of a previous judicial proceeding, evidence of mint officer, certain government scientific experts in that ballistics hai kya? Nahi na? Explosives means ballistics. I'll check that answer. I didn't get time. A scar older than 6 months, what will it do? White glistening and wrinkled. So last MD entrance scars, have they converted white or not? White and wrinkled or not? You are still having that ready scars. No. Now, a horizontal ligature means not much of gravity happened to pull the dead body. That's the reason partial hanging may horizontal ligature is what you typically come across. Then subpoena, what is that? So basically, in a civil case, if the witness fails to come, he can plead the court. Not in criminal case, you cannot tell, sorry, I don't have time last week, okay, I have done a rape. This time I am little busy preparing for MD entrance, you can't tell the judge. But last week you have crossed a traffic signal. Traffic signal, red signal. Magistrate called you. You can tell, no, this week my entrance is there. I will come after entrance is over. Next week I will come for hearing. That you can tell. Civil cases may, you can be prevented, but criminal cases may, it is not. Now, what is an example of an affective learning? So, affective domain means what? It is attitude, motivation, willingness to participate, etc. etc. is all about attitude. What is the purpose of 3 years MD? It is same horizon before MD, after MD. MD is all about attitudinal alteration. Right? You will be thinking, I know Bullenberry, I know everything because I studied Harrison and go to the MD. First case only will be Bullenberry and you will be writing multivitamins and sending home the patient. Then recognize what mistake you have done. So slowly you from academic heights, you will come down to ground level. That is all about MD. Affective domain. Then cognitive domain is what? Basically, it is comprehension, application, analysis, synthesis and evaluation. Something to do with intellect is all about. Cognitive, something to do with attitude is all about. Affective. That's the point. Psychomotor domain means what? Intubation karna, central line dalna, skills is all about psychomotor. Interpersonal means what? How to stop coming to duty and make your colleague to do the night duty is interpersonal domain. You will become experts in that in MD. Now, what is the source of the linoleic acid? So, it is a different sources are given. Groundnut is having highest 40. So, you must be quite sure. Entrance is not all about only intelligence. You need to know Ratnadeep supermarket list also. कोकोनट ऑयल, पाम ऑयल, हेयर ऑयल, शैंपू, शैंपू में परसेंटेज कितना होता है? एक्चुअली बिफोर आफ्टर नोटिफिकेशन बिफोर एंट्रेंस एग्जाम विल गेट हैलुसिनेशंस. Even while taking shampoo, you will be thinking, what percentage is there? This can be an MCQ. So everything looks like an MCQ. And you go to the picture hall and they will try to remember the seat number. By heart the seat number. Because we develop obsession of remembering everything. Every numerical. Just last 15 days of the entrance. Which demographic cycle we are in? Late expanding. Did we change recently? No, no. In a patient with malaria, periodicity of 72 hours is malaria. So you must know tertiary and quaternary, etc. How do we basically define? Unknown confounders ko clinical trial mein nikalne ke liye kya karte? Trial mein randomization karte. Did anybody answer matching? No. That's good. Now for the camp of a few months duration, what is the type of the latrine that need to be chosen? So once more, that different types of latrine design, shallow trench latrine, deep trench latrine. But don't remember how deep it is, how width it is. Life becomes miserable. Miserable in entrance exam. We don't ask such questions, but at least general issues about deep trench latrine, etc. Lay reporting involves basically non-professional health workers. Non-professional health workers say, whenever you take the information, you call lay reporting. You thought it as public? No. Continuous quantitative data. How do you want to do? So two types of data, discrete data, continuous data. What is continuous data? Weight, height, where you can calculate mean value. You call continuous. Discrete means yes or no type of data, where only you can calculate proportion, you can't calculate mean. That is discrete. So histogram is ideal for a quantitative data which is continuous for you to plot. So different statistical pictures, what unique situation will they be used? What is special about one over the other? You have to read. One favorite question of the examiner. Health worker female, how many deliveries she is supposed to do? 9 to 10 per month. Right? 9 to 10 per month. That means remaining 21 days she can stay in home. At least 9 to 10 is all about it. Yeah. Kuppuswamy doesn't include housing but income, occupation and education. Then Parik, Kulakshetra, different scales, you need to read. Rome was introduced by which committee? Srivastava committee. Different committees are there, some funny method to remember. Five committees and entrance may they ask just to I think terrorize students. Which committee? History of medicine doctor. How does it matter to become MD? In my opinion, if I am given a choice, give 200 classical clinical case studies and ask students what is your next step of investigation or a diagnosis or a treatment and decide. Right? Decide. Finish. That should be the way you need to be tested. But entrance is like that. Right? Now, sex ratio in India, actually this question I would have recomposed it. 2011 ka statistics, let us ignore this. When will rupture of myocardium occur? All complications of MI is a favorite topic. So, rupture is a complication when? We gave key as first week. I'll just recheck this. First week is we'll recheck that first week. Yeah. Austin Flint murmur. Pehla ye batao. Austin Flint murmur. Where do you see? aortic regurgitation. It is confused with mitral stenosis ka mid-diastolic murmur. How many didn't understand? Raise the hand. Only three. Alright, don't be too honest. Too modest. Huh? Okay. Give me a cam. One sec, doctor. There is one funda. If I fail to teach, ultimately you will go and tell Dr. Murali Bharadwaj only talks about shallow trench latrine but not about Austin Flint murmur. He will pass on when Austin Flint has come. That should not happen in spite of doing MD general medicine. Okay. Just 3 points I want to tell you. Now, you have the LV, LA. Okay. Then from the LV you are having the aorta. And here you have the aortic valve. And here you have the mitral valve. Right? Aortic regurgitation, when it becomes very severe, what will happen? There is a big flow of blood flowing from aorta into left ventricle. Can you give me a little focus, please? One minute now. Just give a little focus. So when the aortic regurgitation become very severe, instead of small trickling of blood from the aorta into ventricle, what happens? There is a big thunder showers will be falling down. When are they falling? When is aortic regurgitation occurring? When the ventricle is in systole or during diastole? Ventricle undergoes systole, pushes the blood into aorta. When it is undergoing diastole, regurgitation is occurring. So this regurgitation is occurring when the ventricle is during diastole. And diastole is happening from where to where? Left atrium into the left ventricle. Left atrium into left ventricle. So during that time, the left atrium is trying to push the blood into the ventricle. But this backward flow of the aortic regurgitation will clash with the forward flow coming from the left atrium into left ventricle and causes a resistance to the flow which comes from the left atrium into the left ventricle. And because of that, there is a turbulence in the flow, and that lead to the mid-diastolic murmur due to the severe aortic regurgitation, not due to mitral stenosis, right? And what is that called? Austin Flint's murmur of aortic regurgitation. What is that? Summarize. Austin Flint murmur of the aortic regurgitation is a diastolic murmur, mid-diastolic murmur. When the high regurgitant blood is back flowing into the left ventricle, the forward flow of the left atrium into the left ventricle get turbulence, which is then called Austin Flint murmur, mid-diastolic murmur. Right? What is the significance of Austin Flint murmur? Unless aortic regurgitation is severe, you don't have Austin Flint murmur. So, Austin Flint is one of the markers of a severity of the aortic regurgitation, is what you need to remember. That is the story of AR. Then what is mitral stenosis? Mitral stenosis means when there is a stenotic valve, when the left atrium is trying to push the blood into the ventricle, that lead to MDM, mid-diastolic murmur. But what is the difference between this mid-diastolic murmur and this mid-diastolic murmur due to the turbulence? What is the main difference? If you look at the mid-diastolic murmur due to mitral stenosis, you have other findings of the mitral stenosis. What are they? A loud first heart sound will be there. If it is due to mitral stenosis, not due to Austin Flint. There is an opening snap. Only if it is due to mitral stenosis, not due to aortic regurgitation. And what else will be there? whenever the mid-diastolic murmur is there, right, there is a accentuation of this murmur, towards the end of the diastole, end diastolic accentuation means what? S1, S2, S1. Between S1, S2 you call diastole, or S2, S1 you call diastole? S1 is what? Closure of the aortic valve. S2 is what? S1 is closure of mitral valve. S2 is what? Closure of aortic valve. After the closure of the aortic valve, you are having a diastole. There is mid-diastolic murmur somewhere in the middle. When it is reaching towards the end of the diastole, the atrium contracts and pushes the blood. Normally also, atrium last one third of the diastole of the ventricle mate will contract and push the blood. Because of the atrial contraction, this mid-diastolic murmur of the MS, when it is reaching towards the end of the diastole, from behind, the atrium will kick it. So it will say, ah, and then move. So because of that, suddenly, end diastolic accentuation is otherwise called pre-systolic accentuation, whichever you call. At the end of the diastole, before the systole, there is an accentuation which will occur. When the slow running blood is pushed by the contraction of aorta. That pre-systolic accentuation is a feature only of the mitral stenosis ka MDM, but not the Austin Flint's murmur. There is no pre-systolic accentuation. Because pre-systolic accentuation is because of what? Atrial contraction. Trying to push the blood during the last one third of the diastole. That won't affect this turbulence. So Austin Flint doesn't have. So these are the exceptions. But what is the problem when you really diagnose the patient? There can be a patient of mid-diastolic murmur whose mitral valves are calcified, so the S1 is no more loud. There may be a patient of mitral stenosis who is having atrial fibrillation. If the atria is having fibrillation, will you have end diastolic, otherwise pre-systolic accentuation? You cannot have. If the father-in-law is a very angry and a strong man in service, he will have a gun, service rifle, he will shout. But if he is a old, debilitated, decrepit, languid, puny, effete and enervated guy, with a productive cough not coming out of the thorax, can he shout on you? He cannot. So, atrial fibrillation guy is like what? Atrial fibrillation, atria is like a old, sick mother-in-law. She can't shout, she can't get up from the bed, she can't do anything. Then pre-systolic accentuation hota kya? Nahi hoga. So pre-systolic accentuation har martaba hone ka kuch guarantee nahi hai mid MS ka MDM mein. Okay? But if examiner asks, what is the difference between Austin Flint's MDM, which is seen in AR, versus mitral stenosis wala MDM, what will it tell? Opening snap, loud heart sound, pre-systolic accentuation. These additional auscultatory findings are only seen in mid-diastolic murmur, which is due to mitral stenosis, but not due to aortic regurgitation. Another thing is, one aortic regurgitation in Austin Flint is seen only when aortic regurgitation becomes very severe. So when aortic regurgitation is very severe, you have other signs of severity of AR. So based on clinical examination, you should interpret the auscultation, not auscultation alone. Right, doctor? Okay, that is the story.